I kind of expected them all to be running along together in rows, you know, like finishing time in a race.
Yes,
like a mirror image of the same cow over and over. So it's not quite like that.
No, it's not. You know, like I said, they'll act similar, but they don't know they're a clone, and each calf has its own personality.
So just how do you create a clone? Expert cloner Earl Huang is keen to show Olivia just how it's done.
It's still kind of hard to say. Let me see if I can get it. Today we're working with bovine.
So it's a cow egg?
Yes. These eggs come from a slaughterhouse, and what I'm basically doing is taking out all the DNA and creating a blank for the actual cloning process to begin.
So in order to clone, you need an empty egg.
Exactly.
And so you're plunging this glass pipette into the egg and just suctioning out the DNA.
Yes.
It's an extremely delicate operation.
It is. You have to have good hand-eye coordination, and you have to be gentle with the eggs. You don't want to kill them.
And that's what's amazing about cloning. It doesn't require particularly complicated chemistry, just a microscope, a very sharp glass needle, and incredibly steady hands.
And I'll go in with the pipette.
And draw it up like juices from a turkey. I have to say, it's fascinating to see it.
Next, Earl has to hoover up the cells containing the DNA of the animal he wants to clone.
These are cells grown from the skin of the animal that we want to clone.
Exactly.
It amazes me that you can put a cell from a grown-up animal into an empty egg and something happens.
Well, the cell basically contains the whole genetic makeup of that animal.
You now insert the DNA of the animal you want to clone into the empty egg. One cell into each egg.
You can see there's a little pocket of space.
What I'll do is puncture the egg and just carefully deposit the cell in there.
Last of all, you need to wake up the egg containing the new DNA. All it takes is a spark of electricity.
Earl may make it look easy, but in fact it's immensely difficult to pull off in practice. Dolly the sheep was the only survivor of 300 attempts. But if you can master it, the rewards are huge, because once you've found your perfect animal, you can create a clone and repeat it time after time, like a biological photocopier.
How is it better than just having natural reproduction, or just with normal sex and birth?
To get the ideal calf or the ideal genetics, it could take years. When someone wants to clone their animals, they highly value that animal's genetics and they want to keep breeding it. They're not just going to clone it to send it to market.
What's weird is that you or I can actually buy a clone. If you order one of these, it costs $15,000, but you get a reduction if you buy in bulk. The guy who's bought these has cloned them from his own prize-winning longhorns.
These will go to competition.
So the guy might show these clones in a show.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that cheating?
The whole thing seems a bit like cheating to me. And frankly, who'd want to eat a clone anyway?
Would you eat a cloned steak?
Sure, absolutely, absolutely.
In a way, you know that you have those moments where you eat something, it's the best steak I've ever had. Do you just clone that steak and eat it every day for the rest of your life?
Sure. Right, definitely.
I'm shocked by how matter-of-fact everyone seems to be about cloning and by just how much of it is going on.
So then, cloning. That is the keynote scary thing of the whole transgenic GM thing, isn't it? That's the most scary thing of all.
Cloning, to a lot of people, I think, suggests a Xerox copy.
It's exactly what it suggests to me. Yeah.
And that's obviously not what it is. I mean, technically speaking, an identical twin is a clone. Apples, for example, are all clones. Almost all fruit is made by grafting, so as to avoid the genetic lottery.
Well, every apple is there's no unique apples.
Well, we could grow them from seed, but then they'd taste horrible and be useful only for making cider.
In what sense is it a clone?
Apples are grown by grafting, so that you don't have to take the risk of sex. Sex breaks up good gene combinations. The offspring of an apple that tastes good often don't taste very good, because the genes that made your apple taste very good have been shuffled up.
In that case, let's accept the fact that the cloning of an apple is not especially scary, is it? That's not the thing that worries people. It's cloning. It's cloning people. It's cloning cattle for eating that scares people.
Why?
We don't know what the long-term dangers are likely to be. The species not strengthened by constant cross-fertilization.